Morning, Samantha. How are you?
Tired. Why are you calling so early?
Oh, did I wake you? It's 7 o'clock. You should be out and about by now.
It's Sunday.
Those jobs aren't going to apply for themselves. You should be sending out resumes nonstop. How else are you going to break into the business world and make a name for yourself?
Yeah, well...
But enough about that. How was your day last night? He's so charming and funny, isn't he? And such a handsome young man. Didn't you find him charming?
He was... all right.
All right? Just all right? How can that be? Couldn't you see how charming he was? Maybe the lighting was bad in the restaurant.
The lighting was fine. It's just... he spent the whole time talking about himself. His accomplishments and goals and life plans. I could see how you'd like him.
I know, isn't he great? Such a remarkable young man.
Maybe for you. I saw my entire life with him flash before my eyes, and it was everything you've ever wanted.
Everything we've ever wanted, Samantha. Isn't he charming? Maybe it was too loud in the restaurant and you couldn't hear him clearly.
I could hear him fine. I just didn't like what I was hearing.
Oh, Sammy, just give it some time. I'm sure your next date with him will be terrific.
Yeah, I doubt that's gonna happen. He's pretty dull, actually.
Don't be foolish, dear. Any young woman would be lucky to have him. You're a young woman now. You just graduated from a very prestigious university. A great man, family, and career are in your future. But time is ticking. Don't let a few girlish whims deter you. We've wanted this for a very long time.
You've wanted it. I'm not so sure anymore.
Enough of that negative attitude. I don't want to hear it, young lady. Now get out of bed and start job hunting. I love you. Bye.
Wake up! It's running time! It's a beautiful day outside! Come on! Wake up!
Since when?
Since last week! You promised, remember? Well, you did! Come on! Running time! 10 minutes! I'll give you 10 minutes!
Cece, I'm trying to sleep!
10 minutes!
Morning, people.
I don't know, Sammy, from those pictures you showed me, he is dreamy.
It's not just about that. It was like being on a date with a male version of my mom. Never letting her set me up again.
Your mom's a very nice person, and she only wants what's best for you.
She wants what she thinks is best for me. And anyway, you're supposed to be on my side.
Right, sorry. That weasel pretending to be just like your mother to get into your pants.
That's better.
So, did he kiss you?
Yeah.
And how was it? Soft, tender, romantic?
Lackluster.
Lackluster?
Yeah. He walked me to my doorstep, as per the normal First Date Convention Act of 1937. Then he pointed to the stars and said some lame line from a rom-com with Ashton Kutcher. And then he kissed me. And it was dull.
So what's gonna happen next?
Well, if he's anything like anyone else around here, he'll wait 3 days, and then call me for a date next Friday, and then on the third date, the expectation will be sex.
Do guys really expect that? I thought it was just a myth.
The conventional ones do.
So with this guy, it's not true love? Well, for me, it was love at first sight. Those pictures you showed me on Facebook, he's handsome, athletic, ambitious, and he has a job. He's like Prince Charming. He is everything any woman would want.
Not this woman.
Well, anyway, this opportunity doesn't come very often. It's not like you're kissing boys every night of the week.
Well...
Shut up. Who have you been kissing?
You know that masquerade party we went to on Friday?
Who did you kiss? Do you remember that guy with the robot box as his mask?
Box guy? You kissed box guy?
Yeah.
How? When? Why?
It just sort of happened. We were walking through the garden and it seemed like a good idea, I guess.
Ooh, how romantic. So, do you love this guy?
What? No. But I do like him a lot.
Was it love at first sight?
Not exactly. He was a little drunk and lost, and he sort of burst in on me peeing.
What?
Yeah, we didn't get off to a very good start. But after that, we started talking, and he turned out to actually be a pretty cool guy.
So when did he kiss you?
I kissed him, actually. He wouldn't take off his mask, so I decided to do it for him.
How was it? Dreamy?
Sloppy.
Sloppy?
Sloppy, but good.
And then what happened?
Nothing. We hung out for a while, but then we parted ways. I was a little disappointed.
Why?
I kind of wanted him to stay the night.
On the first date?
I know what you're thinking, but it felt right at the time, and it still does. But it didn't happen because he never made a move, and I was nervous waiting for him to make a move, so I didn't make one either.
So is he gonna call you?
No.
Why not? You said you had a great time.
The thing is, he's moving back to Germany tomorrow, so we didn't even bother exchanging phone numbers.
Well, you can find our stuff on Facebook anyway.
Yeah, I tried that, but I don't know anything about him. I don't know his name, his number. I don't even know what he looks like.
You don't know what he looks like? What if he's some kind of creeper? Or an old dude?
He's not an old dude.
Oh my gosh, what if he has huge burn marks all over his face? What if he's ugly?
I doubt it. And anyway, it doesn't matter.
Oh, this is like something out of Shakespeare. Star-crossed lovers, separated by the sea.
Ocean?
Whatever. This is so sad. It's like, you have the worst luck when it comes to love. I guess you just have to, you know, get it over with and move on to the next guy. If the stars don't align, it's not true love.
Screw true love. I just want to see him again.
Don't knock true love. It's euphoric, everlasting, and the only thing worth striving for in this whole world. It's sunshine and flowers all day, every day. It's dreaming.
Hey, get out of the way.
Hey, fuck off!
Okay, back to reality. I still want to see him again.
But what are you gonna do? He's leaving tomorrow, and he doesn't even have your phone number. So even if he wanted to find you, how would he do it?
So, I'll find him.
Find him? What do you mean he's supposed to find you? I mean, what are you gonna do? Go around town putting up wanted posters like some sort of psycho crazy girlfriend?
Maybe I will. I don't have time to wait for him to find me.
Don't be ridiculous. Even if you find him, what then?
It doesn't matter. It's time I start taking control of my own life. And I haven't felt this way about someone for a long time. I'm tired of other people making my decisions for me.
Okay, you sound just a little crazy here. But if that's what you want to do, then I'm not going to stop you. You know who might have some info to help you?
Who?
Jacob. He was talking to Box Guy a lot during the party. Maybe he has a name.
That's a good idea, thanks.
So how are you doing, Sam?
You look great. Are you using a new hair conditioner?
Oh, no, same stuff, and thanks. I'm doing really well.
Well, it looks great. Doesn't it, hon?
Yeah, her hair does look good. Terrific.
Well, where are my manners? Does anyone want some tea or coffee?
I guess I'd like some coffee.
Me too, thanks.
I'll be right back.
So, how are things, Jacob?
Oh, you know, things are pretty good. Apartment's great. Job's great. Overall, never been better. No, why do you ask?
Well, usually there is at least two empty pizza boxes around here, but it's really clean now.
I know what you mean, but no. She still has her own place, although she hardly ever uses it. I've asked her so many times, but whenever I do, she just laughs and says she isn't living here.
Okay, that's good. And how is the relationship?
You know, Sam, it's good. It's like everything else in life, right? You get out what you put in, but can she put out so I can get it in?
Still no sex.
I'm dying here, Sam. We fool around in the same bed every night. You know, she says she won't do it until we're married because of Jesus or something. At least Jesus got nailed. I get nothing.
That bad?
It's building up inside of me. And soon I won't be able to control it, Sam. I really don't know what to do. Every single night, we're just fooling around and I'm left high and dry. Tell me, who do you think would win in a fight between Jesus and the Incredible Hulk?
You guys are talking about comic books again? Grow up, Jacob. Did you know he used to have an imaginary friend as a kid?
I didn't, actually.
Well, it was really good to see you, Samantha.
Yeah, me too.
You said you were here to ask Jacob for some help. What was it again?
Yeah, she came by wanting me to help her find that box guy from the party on Friday. Do you remember him?
Yeah, that hipster doofus. He was funny in his own quirky way. Why do you want to find him anyway?
I like him a lot, and I'd like to spend more time with him.
But she doesn't know anything about him, not his name or what he looks like, and was wondering if I could help. Unfortunately, I don't know those things either. But what I do have is the name and number of that guy who showed up to the party with him.
Oh.
I think his name was David or something.
Oh, great. Thank you. I'll give him a call right now.
Is she crazy? She doesn't even know what that guy looks like. This is weird. She's weird.
It's not weird. It's a little unorthodox, but it's perfectly normal.
Well, why is she so desperate to find him? I hope she's not planning anything unholy.
Unholy? It's just what normal, healthy adults do. It's perfectly normal.
This is not the pathway to heaven.
Pathway to heaven? Oh, I know exactly what my pathway to heaven would be.
I said not until we're married.
Look, I'm pretty sure heaven is just made up to keep guys like me from getting laid.
Well, if it's made up, then why does everyone believe in it? Everyone cannot be wrong. And if you want to get down and dirty, you should do it the pure and honorable way. Marry me.
Marry me?
Yes, marry me. What's the big deal? We're already living together.
I knew it. All those times I asked and you wouldn't say, and finally you admitted. Hey, Sam.
He's not picking up right now, but I'll try him later on. Thanks.
Okay, cool. Listen, if you're gonna go see this David guy, just take care of yourself. He's sometimes... I'm sure you'll be fine. But just watch out for him. Do you need anything else from us?
Can I borrow your bike?
Maybe. Do you have a plan in mind?
Something like that.
Okay, but please, take good care of her.
I will, I promise. Bye!
See, oh, hang on! Safety first.
Thanks. Bye.
Password?
Elementary.
Come in.
Hey, how's it going?
Can't complain. What about you? What have you been up to?
Oh, just putting up posters, trying to find a guy I met at a party.
Any luck?
Not so far. A few people texted me addresses, but they were all just pranks.
Pranks? Where did you end up?
Oh, so far, a sex shop, a strip club, a homeless shelter, a police station, and a mental institution recently.
Well, no doubt. I mean, your strategy is all wrong. You're basically just doing trial and error all over the city.
Well, I'm totally out of leads now. What do you think I should do?
Well, you should do some deduction. I mean, just narrow down your search area.
Well, how the hell am I supposed to do that? I literally don't know anything about this guy.
So, you know nothing about this guy, and yet you're willing to do all this just to find him. Must have been quite the date. I mean, what did you guys even talk about?
Everything? Except ourselves. It just never came up because we were so busy talking about more interesting things.
Damn. You go, girl. I mean, don't let these other sheep tell you what to do. Fuck normal, right?
So, how do I narrow down my search?
Well, you can think back to the last time that you guys were together. Search your memory. Anything you remember can help. Anything small.
But I know he didn't say anything about himself.
It doesn't need to be something that he said. It could be something that he ate, something, I mean, like how his breath smelled, what he was wearing. Honestly, anything small and identifiable could work.
Nothing out of the ordinary.
Think harder. What was he wearing?
A green shirt.
Okay, good. A green shirt. What brand?
Urban Outfitters, I think.
Okay, so... was it dirty?
No, it was clean.
Which means that he does his laundry regularly. How faded was it?
What?
Like, the color of the shirt, how faded was it?
A little faded?
On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being way too faded to wear to any party, what is it?
Like, maybe a 6?
Okay, good. So a 6. Assuming it's plus or minus 1 and that the average male in their 20s does laundry about 8 times a year, coupled with the fact that Urban Outfitters makes less than standard quality t-shirts, it's safe to say that he probably purchased it about 15 months ago.
Okay.
Now, Urban Outfitters had one green shirt on the market 15 months ago. There were 73 stores selling it worldwide.
Great, 73 worldwide.
So you mentioned before that he had a cardboard box mask?
Yeah.
Where was the box from? Think.
Oh, I remember. It was written on one of the sides. Home Depot.
Was it like a perfect cube?
Pretty close.
Okay, so it seems that Home Depot has two different products that they sell in perfect cubic boxes, cross-referencing Home Depot stores with cubic boxes with green shirt stores 15 months ago. I got it.
Really?
There are only two residences that are within a 3-kilometer radius of both an Urban Outfitters that sold a green shirt 15 months ago and a Home Depot that sells perfect boxes. One is in Belgium, but the other, much more likely scenario, is right here in Toronto at 139 Constance Boulevard.
Idiot.
Hello?
Did you call and text me before?
Yeah, hi! This is Samantha. We met at that party on Friday. I don't know if you remember me.
Party? What party?
The masquerade. You came with a guy wearing a box.
Masquerade? Box? What?
I don't have time to do this over the phone. I need to find that guy. I'll come over. Where do you live?
Alright. Okay, whatever.
Welcome, welcome.
Thanks. Were you sleeping?
I was just taking a power nap. Didn't think you were coming till 5, sugar.
It is 5.
Oh, you meant PM. Right on. Anyways, please take a seat. I'm sorry, did you want some?
Oh, no, thanks.
Girl, you can help your pretty ass to anything here. It's all great stuff. Finest quality. Health is important, you know?
Right. No, I'm good, thanks. I had a big meal before I got here.
You girls, always worrying about your figure. Go figure.
Why do you keep it so dark in here?
Too many distractions outside, you know? Can't keep my focus. Darkness helps. So does this stuff.
Right.
So who are you again, baby girl? And what you doing in my crib?
I'm Samantha. We met at that masquerade party on Friday.
Masquerade party? I don't remember no masquerade party, but that does sound like something I'd go to. And you seem legit. I'll give you that.
You don't remember? How do you not remember? You have to remember. My entire day rests on you remembering.
Huh? What do you mean? Hey, those are some great shoes, by the way. Where'd you get them?
Oh, thanks. They're from Forever 21. What I mean is I need to find out who that guy is that you came with, who wore the box. I heard he was your friend.
I don't really have any friends that are boxes.
He's not a box. He was wearing a box.
I see. And, where did he get this box?
Home Depot.
Mm-hmm. And what was its shape?
I'm not going through this again. The point is, you know the guy who came with him to the party. I saw you.
Okay, okay. Don't get your panties all up in a bunch, girl. Honestly, I'm just trying to help. Anyways, I can't remember none of what y'all saying.
Do you suffer from memory loss?
Hell no. Why do you ask? Hey, those are some great shoes, by the way. Where'd you get them?
Maybe you shouldn't take so many drugs. Might be affecting your memory.
Slow down, sister. I ain't going to your crib telling you how to live your life. What are you, one of them conformists coming in here trying to tell me what to do? What are you, my mom?
That's not what I mean. My point is, not all rules are stupid.
Maybe. But you know what else helps with memory? Cocaine. Would you like some?
No. Are you really sure that's a good idea?
Best idea? I've had all day. Nothing. Maybe one more. I remember.
Oh my God, are you serious? God damn it.
911,
what's the location of your
emergency?
Hey, Christina.
Hey, Sam. Did you find the guy?
No. My druggy source overdosed on me.
David? Is he dead?
No, he's in stable condition, but I wasted 3 hours in the emergency room.
It's getting dark. I think it's time to call it quits. You gave it a good effort and made a complete fool of yourself. We're having a small dinner with friends here tonight. Goodbye.
Yeah, I guess. Sure.
So, does that mean you're coming?
Yep.
Great. See you soon.
Sam isn't here yet.
Oh, you know what? I just got a text from her. Sorry, I can't make it. I got one more lead to chase.
You owe me $5.
I don't get this girl. I mean, what is she trying to accomplish?
Even if she finds this guy, he's leaving tomorrow. What is she hoping for?
It's not about that for her. It's not about what will or won't happen. Today's more about taking control. It's about not letting conformity and social pressure restrict her from the opportunities she sees. It's about letting her make her own future, I think.
Wow. Deep. Oh, she sent another text. P.S. Tell Jacob, sorry I lost his bike.
God damn it, Sam.